police officer sees that, okay, there is drug activity, there is gang-related activity, they would stop and search that person because they had reasonable suspicion. Arguably, it's a lesser standard, right? Probable cause standard is also if there is a probability that this merchandise is made by the slave labor, but it falls within the section 307, then they will issue the finding. Because the finding is has a higher evidence threshold than the withhold release order, which requires reasonable. Remember that the reasonable suspicion, which is like lesser standard. If it's reasonable, like I have a reason to believe based on information, but that information maybe come from an unreliable source, right? Whereas here, this finding came with a conclusive evidence. Again, the terms are vague, right? But those are the words we have to deal with. Finding will result in a seizure of merchandise, whereas withhold release order, because the evidence which was applicable to this withhold release order was not really conclusive, right? Customs will allow you to take the merchandise out or contest the withhold release order. Finding is more strict. It results in seizure. So once you bring it in, once you file it, once the merchandise is within customs custody, they have to take it. They have to seize it. You cannot get it back. Under withhold release order, you can get it back. All right. So, and this is an important point to notice because the fact that you can export it also places a certain time frame, and that time frame for the withhold release order, either contested or take it out, is 3 months. All right. Importer must contest with withhold release order within 3 months after the date of importation. The date of importation, also recall, is a term of art. Date of importation is defined in our general provisions section. And our general provisions is 101, right? Part 101, 101.1 definitions. Let's see. Date. Date of importation right there, right? Date of importation means, in the case merchandise imported by vessel, ship, ocean, date of importation means the date on which vessel arrives within the port limits of a port, number one, in the United States with intent then and there to unload such merchandise. So, meaning the United States is the final country of destination, it's not just a transship point. Of course, let's see. Of course, the first one, if it arrives by other than by vessel, like by plane or by train, the date on which merchandise arrives within customs territory of the United States. So keep this also date of importation in mind as you study for as you prepare for the broker exam. Another part where it is defined is CBP Form 7501 instructions. All right, so if a merchandise, so next exam question deals with this 3 months time frame. If merchandise is withheld, right, from release order, so now withhold release order, right, can also be called a detention order. Detention order, because the merchandise is really not seized, it's detained, right? So if it is subject to the detention order, then the rules guiding the detention can also be arguably applicable. And what would be the regulation, a very important section dealing with detention of merchandise? It's really hidden in the Code of Federal Regulation, but it's hugely important in the practice. Let me see. Here, 151.16, detention of merchandise. Very, very important provision, which can save a lot of grief to you and your client in the real life. It deals with the procedure, so there is a 5-day period where customs must present notice of examination, and sometimes customs would not do this on the ground, so you must demand this notice because it starts kicks off that legal period. So be mindful. We have a whole separate discussion on this, so I'm not going to dwell too much. Then there is a 30-day window, and then there is a protest period, which establishes whole procedural mechanism in place to contest customs decision. Not going to spend too much time on this because we have a whole different topic, detention of merchandise topic, and a whole different chapter dedicated just to that. But there is overlap. So 3 months period. If merchandise is withheld from release, so it's detained by CBP due to an active withhold release order, an importer has up to and then blank after the article was imported to provide information to CBP to contend that its goods were not mined, produced, or manufactured with or any form of labor specified in section 307, or meaning that it was not produced by forced labor. So 3 months is the correct answer. This is something that you just have to know to answer it correctly. So be mindful of identifying key phrases and key provisions for the withhold release order. Withhold release order, be mindful that this is not the same as finding. If there was a finding, then there was no the customs must seize the merchandise. There is no that 300 rebuttal period, 3 months rebuttal period. It will immediately be seized. Alright, the question is then, how do you contest it? Well, you provide information and documents. You provide certificate of origin, which establishes the chain of custody, statement by ultimate consignee, report by ultimate consignee. Alright? So this establishes the procedure. Information from public non-CBP, anyone who has a reason to believe that merchandise is produced by convict forced indentured labor, can go to customs and tell the particular information. One example of this particular information that was submitted to customs is for the country called Turkmenistan. So this is one. This is a petition that is available on their website, cottoncampaign.org. So in this petition to Commissioner Kelikovsky on April 6, 2016, they say that IKEA. Everyone, well, probably many folks heard about IKEA, it's a furniture store. They use particular covers and pillowcases from Turkmenistan, and those particular covers and pillowcases are made from forced labor. Forced labor, right? And because of that, they ask commissioner to exclude those IKEA orders. And here they have a 6 pages of description. They cite the regulations and sign it, execute it appropriately, and see what says, and hope that commissioner excludes the merchandise. Now, the commissioner on its end may issue detention order such as it did here, or may not. And the way to find this, although they say it's published in the Federal Register, you have this CBP dedicated web page to the convict and forced labor. And at the bottom, they have a list of orders which include detention orders or withhold release orders and findings. And those findings have a list of names of entities that use that forced labor and the description of the commodity with which this forced labor was used. For findings, remember, the seizure is a must. And for detention order, that 3-month period to contest is a must, or they can export it. But it's a good idea to keep this list in mind because it's better if you are on notice and this is all public, right? Then it's a better idea not to bring this from this guy in the first place because you know you have issues. Remember I mentioned that this is sort of a rare occurrence, right? And because it's a rare occurrence, then notice the frequency. Out of the whole world, this is how many, 90, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have a spike in 1991, you had some in 1992, right? So 1991, 1992, 1993 were 4, 5 were somewhat active, but then it stopped, right? And then it was renewed in 2016. Notice, 2016, very recent. You have the mineral products, right? From China, right? Then you have peel garlic, right? All this bang, 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 right after the Trade Enforcement Trade Facilitation Act. So there was a huge break in between this, and then it renewed, it spiked up. And because it spiked up, it made kind of its way into the customs broker exam. I suspect that because this is becoming more popular, more current, the list will grow. Keep this in mind because this is an ever-increasing topic which is likely to be on a customs broker license exam. Keep in mind this list, keep in mind these provisions. All right, so let's see. So here is a flow chart. Let me make it a little bigger, which I include at the end of the outline. I hate to simplify things because a lot of those things take into consideration much more administrative procedure. But for the sake of customs brokerism, I think this will suffice just to get an idea. This is section 307. If you have reasonable standard and you have conclusive standard, then you have different application. The reasonable one is withhold release order, the conclusive standard is the finding. If the finding, then you can only contest it because otherwise it will be seized pursuant to the forfeiture proceedings, right? If you contest it successfully, it will be released. So in other words, you say you provide conclusive, you provide very, very persuasive evidence that it is released, right? If you have withhold release order, then you can do three things. You can either export it within 3 months, you can contest it within 3 months after the date of importation, or you can abandon it, meaning just don't have it. So which will be similar to the seizure, right? Because you don't have a possession of the item. If you contest it, you can release it, or if it's unsuccessful, right? If you fail to establish, the merchandise will be excluded from the entry, which means you can still still export because the standard under the WRO is much less than under the finding. All right, so this is a picture for forced labor.